Welcome. This is the last lab from the quest intro to machine learning, image processing. So let's scroll down, open, extract, analyze, and translate. It is 50 minutes, an expert, and we are going to get charged. Okay, this is a message for me. I'm ready. I will start the lab. I'm not a robot. Okay, the credentials are ready, so I copied, but this time I'm not in an incognito window or private mode, so I right click over here and I will open it on private one. And over here I'm going to put the credentials. I have to go back. Let me share my screen like this, better. Accept, confirm. It doesn't matter because we are using a student account, but for your real project it's always a good idea to have a two-way authentication. We need to wait for the last pop-up. Accept the terms, agree and continue. I'm pretty sure that we will need to open CloudCell, so I'm activating this now and I'm authorizing to continue. So let's scroll down. As you can see, we don't have a score here. So if you want just to finish this lab after 5 minutes or 10 minutes in order to get the badge, you can do it. As you remember, it's always a good idea to use this command to check your let me authorize it, to check your account. As you can see, we are using the student account. If in any case I was not on the incognito and was doing my project, I would see my account. And second, always check if you are working on the correct project. As you can see, this is the project ID, it's this one. So we can continue. We want to go to API and services and then to credentials. So over here, API services, we can go directly to credentials. And we want to create. It takes a little time. Okay, it is ready. So what we want to do now is click over here, create, and we want the API key. You can always copy it and paste it on your text editor, or just close, because exactly the same API key, we can find it here also. So let's scroll down. We need to save this image as sine JPEG. So it's JPEG sine, and I want it to go not here. Here. Now we have it on our computer. We want to transfer it, to upload it to the cloud. So let's go over here to storage. Let's close this one. Create a bucket. we need to give a unique name. So I always say when I'm using the labs, I'm always saying the project ID, which is unique. And let's create it. Over here, you can see the monthly cost. And now we can upload the file over here. It is completed. We can close it. Let's go on the right because we need to give permissions. So add an entry, we want to be public, all users, reader, and save it. Let me scroll a little bit up. Okay. I was sure that we forgot something, so before continue, copy your API key from here, from, let's go to API and credentials, services, and then to the credentials. Okay, let's copy it from here and paste it over here. And now we can just write API key and we're going to be ready. Let's scroll down to continue with our lab. Now we can create a request JSON. We can either use a command line editor like Nano, Vim, or Emacs, but I prefer to open this over here in a new window, my editor, and let's save it. As a JSON file. Over here, file, new file, paste the name. It is ready. So all I have to do now is take this and put it in here and be careful, it says my bucket name. So we have to replace this with the storage bucket name that we have already given. I gave this one. Now we can save it either with a Control S because I'm using Windows, or go over here and save it as well. Now we're going to get the text detection and let's copy this code. Let's go back to our terminal and paste. Let me resize it. So as you can see, we have got a lot of things over here that it is assign languages France. We have space. And it is a text. We have already done these steps. And now we are going to use this JSON file. Again, change the name of the bucket. save it. And now we are going to see the text detection feature of the Vision API. So let's copy the code and paste it here, run it. Again, we have friends, the text, where it is on the sign, the language. And we can run also this command, as you can see, because we are going to see it later. Now let's create a translation request JSON. So let's come over here and go file, new file, and inside this file let's paste. Q is the target, your text here, and target is going to be English. And now we can save it, file, save, and run this command in order to have the translation. And now we are ready to get the result. And to see the response. So the sign, if we scroll up, Pour Obama la moutarde de Dijon, in English means to the public good the dispatches for Obama, the mustard is Dijon. So I don't know French. Or maybe I know a little bit. And also we can analyze the image text with the NLP API. And let's create an NL request JSON first. So let's come here, file, new file, request. And let's copy the code and paste it here, and we need to save it, don't forget to save it. Great. And over here we say that it is a plain text. We have two choices, plain text or HTML, and the content is what we want to have. Now let's run this one. And let's get the result of it. As you see, we have Dijon, which is a location. We have Obama, which is a person. And also here we have a Wikipedia for Barack Obama, if you want to check it. Public group, which is other. And over here we can see the economics for public group. And that's it. So this is a student's account, so I don't care if I just press the X over here. But always on your project, remember to stop your engine, if you have any engine. We don't have any compute engine, virtual machine or app engine, just want to check. And delete whatever you have stored in order to not get charged extra money. So now I don't care about that, I'm using a student account, so I just can just press the X Yes, I want to go. Open it. And I'm ready. I can press EdLab. OK. And cancel. So today we finished with the computer vision API. We extracted, analyzed, and translated text from images with CloudML. It's always a good practice after each lab to go and read the documentation from Google Cloud. It will help you not only get better working with the Google Cloud, but also prepare you for the Google Cloud certification. Thank you for watching this video. Bye.